the topic of our morning devotion was
昨天我们早上的主题是什
么？ Rise up and make
起来
your bed.
做。
And the topic, does anyone remember of our morning devotion today is
你们记得我们今天早上的
Rise up and go. Very good.
主题是什么吗？起来。
Now I need to give you a warning. I need to give you a warning.
我需要给你一个警告。
This message will make you uneasy.
这个信息呢，会让你觉得不安。
It will make you uncomfortable.
会让你觉得不舒服。
And there will be an appeal.
这里会有呼召。
Not for everyone.
不是给所有人。
But only for a few of you.
是给这些被呼召的人。
But I have a burden on my heart.
在我心中有一个负担。
And so I'm very sure, very certain God has given me evidence that He wants me to preach that message.
我很确定上帝呢叫我要讲这个篇道理。
So don't be terrified.
所以你们不要害怕。
But be earnest.
但是你们要虔诚。
And thinking.
想想
and praying as we study the Bible.
当我们在查考圣经的时候呢，你们继续祷告。
Because I believe God is calling.
因为我相信上帝呼召你。
Some of us.
其中的一群人。
To special and unique work.
要做这个特别的工作。
And before we start our Bible study.
在还没有开始的时候。
Shall we not bow our knees and pray to our mighty God?
让我们一起跪下，做一个开会的祷告。
Dear Father in heaven,
我们在天上的父
Thank you so much for this conference.
非常感谢你让我们有这个大会
Thank you so much for the blessings that we have received.
感谢主您赐福于我们
Thank you for everything that you have done for us so far.
感谢您为我们所做的一切
And now,
现在
we thank you for a new day and for life and for strength.
我们感谢您赐福的新的一天让我们有力量
And for the opportunity to open your word and read.
也有呢，这个机会让我们打开你说说的话，让我们一起能够阅读。
We thank you for the ability to think.
我们感谢你，让我们有这个思考的能力。
And for the opportunity to voluntarily respond to your calling.
也有这个机会呢，能够自愿的接受你的呼召。
So I ask that the Holy Spirit.
所以我求主您赐下。
Will fill our minds.
圣灵会赐配降于我们。
And show us your perspective.
让我们知道你的旨意。
That we may see what's your plan for our life.
我们可以看见你对我们的蓝图。
So we ask that you will remove all hindrances and all obstacles.
我这样求主您除去这些障碍。
That would hinder you to bless us.
会阻止您赐福于我们。
And touch our hearts.
求主您触动我们的心。
Speak to us.
和我们说话。
Through the power of your word.
就用你这有力量的话语。
This is our prayer.
这是我们的祷告。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now, yesterday,
昨天,
we talked about the church in an almost perfect condition.
我们已说到了这个教会还有所有最好的情况。
Does anyone remember the verse of our little box that says that the church is totally fine?
你们记得那些章节是说到这个非常好的教会吗?
What verse were we looking at?
我们看到第几节?
Acts chapter 9.
《使徒行传》第九章
Verse 31
第三十一节
Let's read that again
让我们再读
Then the church throughout all Judea, Galilee and Samaria had peace and were edified and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit they were multiplied
第三十一节那时犹太加利利撒玛利亚各处教会都得平安被建立凡事敬畏主蒙圣灵的安慰人数就增多了
Although the churchwas in a very good condition,
虽然呢，这个教会是在一个很好的情况之下。
It was not already done with its work.
但是呢，它的工作还没有完成。
The church was perfect,
这个教会是完美的。
But not complete.
但是还不是完整。
As we will see, something was still missing.
我们看到呢，有些东西遗失了。
Do you remember what verse we just read together as a promise to claim?
你知道刚才我们读了哪一个章节吗？
Just a few minutes ago,
就是几分钟之前
before United Prayer,
在还没有这个合一祷告之前
you all were reading a verse on the screen.
我们都在这个这个荧幕上读了一个章节
What verse did we read?
你读了什么
Acts chapter 1, verse 8.
使徒行传第一章第八节
And let's read microscopically.
使徒行传一章八节
As our beloved brother Randy Skid would say.
让我们仔细阅读
Microscopically, right?
Randy Skid 所说的仔细阅读。
In verse 8 it says,
第八节,
But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you.
但圣灵降临在你们身上，你们就必得能力。
Had the Holy Spirit come, yes or no?
这个圣灵降配了吗？
Had the church received power?
这个教会得到力量了吗？
Yes. Let's read.
让我们读。
And you shall be my witnesses, you shall be witnesses to me.
做我的见证。
In Jerusalem.
并要在耶路撒冷。
And in all Judea and Samaria.
和撒玛利亚。
And how does the verse finish?
这个怎样完成呢？
And unto the end of the earth.
直到地极。
Let's go back to Acts 9.
那我们会回到了这个《使徒行传》第九章。
Let's read microscopically.
让我们仔细的阅读。
Verse 31.
第三十一节。
Then the churches,
的教会,
throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria,
直到犹太、加利利、撒玛利亚各处,
had peace and were edified, and so on and so forth.
都得平安被建立。
Is there something missing here? Yes or no?
你们看这两个句子有什么东西不见了吗？
What do you miss?
什么东西不见了?
What is missing here?
什么东西不见?
The last step.
直到地极。
At first, the church was only in Jerusalem.
一开始呢，这些教会只在耶路撒冷。
But then, when there was danger of being too easy and too comfortable in Jerusalem,
但是呢，因为他们太平安、太稳妥，这是一个危机。
God was pushing them into Judea.
所以呢，耶稣就推了他们去到
and Samaria.
撒玛利亚、犹太。
By persecution.
就用逼迫。
And then the persecution ended.
然后逼迫完成了。
And the church was firmly established in Judea and Samaria.
所以呢，在撒玛利亚、犹太呢国呢，都有很多的教会兴起。
And they had peace.
他们又有的平安。
They were edified.
他们被建立了。
They were walking in the gospel. They were walking in the fear of the Lord.
他们走在上帝的道路上。
They were filled with the Holy Spirit.
他们有这个圣灵的配将。
The church was growing.
这个教会被兴起。
We can say hallelujah.
我们可以说 hallelujah.
But they still were not doing the full commission.
但是呢，他们还没完成他们的使命。
Meaning，
意思是
，Your church can be perfect，
你的教会可以完美
，full of the Holy Spirit，
充满了圣灵
，full of right doctrines，
充满了真正的教义
，and doing zealous mission work，
做这个宣教的布道
，and still something can be missing that God has told you to do。
但是其实还遗失了一些上帝叫你说的事。
So if you look around in your spiritual life and everything is well,
所以当你看你的生命当中，你的属灵状况非常良好。
It does not mean that God might still have another calling for you.
并不是说呢，上帝还没有其他的呼召，他正在呼召你。
That God still may have a task to do.
他还有预备了一个事项要你进行。
And that task was very clearly defined by Jesus.
这个事项呢是非常的仔细，已经清楚的耶稣已经说了。
Go into all the world.
去到地极。
Preach the gospel.
宣讲上帝的福音。
To every creature.
直到每一个人。
Which includes every nation, every kindred, every tongue, every people.
各国各族各邦各民。
So this story in Acts 9.
所以呢，这个在《使徒行传》第九章
goes on，
这里继续说到
Peter had been in Lydda，
彼得在这个地方
healing Aeneas，
在吕大，他已经医治了这个以尼亚。
Then he went to Joppa，
然后呢，他又去到约帕
，and he was resurrecting Tabitha，
他就复活了大比达
，Dorcas，
就是多加，
领养
是领养
，right，
对不对
？And now the chapter changes， but the story doesn't change。
这个章节改变了，可是故事还没有改变。
The next story is just the third part of a three-part series.
下一个故事呢，就是其实这三篇的第三篇。
And we often don't see this because of the chapter division.
因为我们看不见，是因为这个章的换。
So let's read chapter 10 verse 1.
所以让我们读第十章第一节。
I like this story.
我喜欢这个故事。
Because I have a younger brother.
因为我有一个弟弟。
In fact, I have three younger brothers.
其实我有三个弟弟。
And the youngest one is 17 years younger than me.
最小的呢是比我小17岁。
And his name is Cornelius.
他的名字叫哥尼流。
So in verse 1 it says, there was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius.
在该撒利亚有一个人名叫哥尼流。
But this Cornelius was not a first name.
这个
Cornelius here is not a first name.
哥尼流呢并不是他的主姓名的姓。
Cornelius back then was a family name.
Oh, sorry. 哥尼流呢其实他姓并不是他的名。
There was a family of Cornelius.
其实他们有个家族叫做哥尼流。
It was a very old Roman family.
是个非常旧的罗马家庭。
In fact, we know many Roman politicians bearing that family name.
我们都知道呢，很多这些罗马的政治人物都是用这个家族名称。
He was a descendant of a very influential political family.
他是一个非常有这个侵略性一个影响力的这个家庭。
The verse goes on to say a centurion who of what was called the Italian regiment.
然后这里继续说到是意大利营的百夫长。
He could have been in Rome just pursuing a political career.
其实呢，他可以留在罗马那里继续的成长他的这个政治的这个事业。
But seemingly he was an adventurer.
可是呢，他是非常有冒险精神
的。Now what about this Italian regiment?
然后这里说到意大利的意大利的营。
Whether you believe me or not.
你相信吗？
We know this regiment actually from history.
我们这个意大利的营呢，从历史中有说到。
As some of you may know, I like history.
有些人你们知道我很喜欢历史。
So we find in history.
所以我们找到这个历史。
And you don't need to translate that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. The Roman name was Cohors the Second Civium Italia Civium Romanorum.
这个就是这个古时的名字。
It was actually not a part of the regular army.
这个并不是一个普通的这个军队。
Because the regular army at that part of the Roman Empire was composed of Syrians.
因为呢，那时候这个普通的军队呢，他们是都是叙利亚人。
But besides the regular army, there were special troops.
在这个普通的军队里面，其实它有一个特营特兵。
They would help the regular army.
他们会帮助这些普通的军队。
And this group was special forces that were actually real Italians, Europeans.
所以这个特兵呢，他们是真正的这个欧洲人，就是意大利人。
They would serve as volunteers in Palestine.
他们在巴勒斯坦呢做志愿者。
All of them were archers.
全部呢都是这个射箭手。
So Cornelius, he was very good in shooting with bow and arrow.
所以呢，哥尼流他是非常很好的，是一个好的射箭手。
And the Bible says he was a centurion.
然后这里说到他是一个百夫长。
Which means he was not a general.
他并不是一个将军。
He was not even the leader of the entire 1,000 troop group.
他也不是带领了这些整千的这个兵队。
But he was the leader of 100 men.
他只是带领了100个兵。
So he was an officer.
他是一个领队。
But he was not only a military man of noble descent.
他不是一个，当然并不是没有人不知道他。
Read verse 2.
我们读第二节。
A devout man and one who feared God with all his household, who gave alms generously to the people and prayed to God always.
第二节，他是个虔诚的人，他和他全家都敬畏上帝，多多筹集百姓，常常祷告上帝。
Most probably he came as a young adventurer just to have fun in Palestine as a soldier.
有可能呢，他是一个年轻的冒险家，他要来到这个巴勒斯坦呢，来寻找刺激。
But somehow he learned about the God of the Hebrews.
可是呢，他认识了这个希伯来人的神上帝。
And he saw the beauty of the Old Testament.
他看这个旧约的美好。
And he prayed to the God of heaven.
他就向上帝祈祷。
To the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob.
他就为这个亚伯拉罕、雅各的神祷告。
And when there was ASI in Judah,
当时在这个犹大有这个 ASI 的时候，
he would always give big donations.
他都会有这个给很多的这个捐款。
When AOY came to Caesarea,
如果这个 AOY 去到这个地方呢，
he would send a large check.
他也会给一个很大的支票。
There was one problem.
没有问题。
There was one problem.
但是有个问题。
He could not attend AOY.
他不会参加 AOY.
He was not allowed to go to ASI.
他不能够去到 ASI 这个。
Because he was not allowed to be a church member.
因为呢，他不能做这个教友。
Because he was from a different race and a different religion.
因为呢，他有不同的信仰，他是不同的人。
Later in the chapter, Peter very clearly says.
过后呢，我们学到彼得非常清楚的说到。
It is unlawful for a Jew to have contact with a Roman.
因为呢，是有这个犹太人和异邦人一起有交流呢，是不合法的。
Meaning.
意思是。
It was against the law for the Roman to become a member of the Jewish church.
就是呢，在那个时候，犹太的这个教会呢，他们有这个律法说，外邦人和犹太人不能够交流。
Sound familiar?
你们听到吗
？I told you, you will be uneasy.
我告诉你，你会觉得不安。
Our topic is.
我们的主题是。
Rise up.
起来。
And go.
去。
Now, he really wanted to be a part of the church.
他真的想要这个教会的一份子。
But he couldn't.
但是他不行。
He was not circumcised.
他没有割礼。
He was not a Jew.
他不是犹太人。
So the Jews would say he's a nice man.
所以这个犹太人说，哇，你是一个很好的人。
And we really like his money.
我们很喜欢你的捐款。
But still he's a sinner.
可是你是罪人。
Because he's of a different race.
因为你是不同种族。
And he's of a different religion.
你是不同的信仰。
He doesn't belong to us.
你并不属于我们。
And they would not have any real contact with him. He would not be in their church circles.
所以呢，他们不能与他们交流，不能同他们一起吃吃饭。
But someone did not.Someone did not bother about human laws.
但是有一个人呢，他们并不有一个人呢，他们并不重人的律法。
You know who that person was?
你知道他是谁吗？
Jesus Christ.
就是我们的耶稣基督。
So when he saw Cornelius,
所以当他看到哥尼流的时候，
he sent an angel.
他差派了一个天使。
Verse 3.
第三节。
About the ninth hour of the day, he saw clearly in a vision an angel of God coming in and saying to him, Cornelius.
有一天约在深处，他在异象中明明看见上帝的一个使者进去，到他那里说：“哥尼流。”
You know it's significant if an angel of God comes down and calls you by name.
你知道吗？这个天使呢，叫你的名字是这么特殊的。
Leave your finger in Acts 10. Go with me to Isaiah 43.
我们去到以赛亚书第四十三章。
Reading verse 1.
我们第一节。
But now thus says the Lord who created you, O Jacob, and He who formed you, O Israel.
雅各啊，创造你的耶和华以色列啊，造成你的那位。
Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine.
现在如此说，你不要害怕，因为我救赎了你，我曾提你的名召你是属我的。
An angel from heaven comes down and says, Cornelius.
有一个天使来到这里，叫他哥尼流。
God is calling you by your name.
上帝在叫你的名呼召你。
You are a child of God.
你是上帝的孩子。
Yes, you may be still in Babylon.
也许你还在巴比伦。
But you are a child of God.
但是你是上帝的孩子。
Go back with me to Acts 10.
我们去到使徒行传第十章。
Verse 4.
第四节。
And when he observed him, he was afraid and said, "What is it, Lord?"
哥尼流定眼看着他，惊怕说：“主啊。”
So he said to him, "Your prayers and your alms have come up before a memorial before God."
什么事呢？天使说你的祷告和你的周祭达到上帝面前以蒙纪念。
In other words, even if the church is not really paying attention to you.
另外一句话说呢，就是虽然这个教会并没有注意到你。
There's a God in heaven.
可是上帝在天国。
Who sees in secret.
他已经秘密的观察你了。
Who sees into the secret chambers of the heart.
他已经看到你心里的内心的秘密想法。
Who sees every good work.
他看到你做的好事。
Who sees the real intention.
他看到你所想要的。
And God in heaven.
我们在天父上帝
accepts you as a child of God.
接受你成为天国的孩子。
Now imagine you're Cornelius.
想想你是哥尼流。
That must have been great news, right?
这是非常极大的消息。
I'm accepted.
我被接受了。
I'm a child of God.
我是上帝的孩子。
I'm saved.
我得救了。
But listen to the angel.
但是你看这个天使说，第五节。
Now send men to Joppa and send for Simon whose surname is Peter.
现在你当打发人往约帕去，请那称呼彼得的西门来。
He is lodging with Simon the Tanner, whose house is by the sea. He will tell you what you must do.
他住在海边一个俏皮匠西门的家里，房子在海边。向他说话的天使过世后
，Wait a minute.
你应该要做什么
？Wait a minute.
等等。
Here we have an angel from God coming down from heaven.
这有一个天使从天上降下来。
And he's telling Cornelius, you are saved.
他告诉哥尼流，你得救了。
And what would you expect him to do next?
然后你觉得哥尼流应该要做什么呢？
Give him a Bible study?
他们要坐下来读经吗？
I mean, dear angel,
这个天使，
why are you not just telling him what needs to be told?
为什么他不要直接告诉他你要做什么？
So the angel is coming down,
然后天使降世站在世
上， saying to Cornelius,
然后跟哥尼流说
You're a saved man.
你得救了。
Now you need to go to Peter.
你要去找彼得。
And he will tell you the rest.
还告诉你要怎样做。
Why is not the angel giving the Bible study?
为什么这个天使不要和他查经呢？
Do you think the angel was not able to give the Bible study?
你觉得是天使他不能够做这个查经吗？
Would the angel be able to tell everything about the crucifixion and all the Bible studies? Yes or no?
这天使能不能够告诉他这关于耶稣钉在十字架上还有其他的福音呢？
So why is he referring?Cornelius to Peter.
可是呢，为什么他叫哥尼流去找彼得呢？
Why is he referring Cornelius to Peter?
为什么他叫哥尼流去找彼得？
God wants.
上帝要。
That everyone is not only saved.
每个人并不是单单得救。
But also a member of the church.
也是教会的教友。
God doesn't only want children.
上帝不是要他，不只单单要他孩子。
He also wants them to be siblings.
他们也要。把他们当作兄弟姐妹。
You understand what I mean? He doesn't only want single person saved.
他不是要一个人得救。
But he wants them to be united in one church.
而是要他们合一，成为一教会。
And for that reason, a task that could be easily done by angels is given to human beings.
因此呢，其实给天使来说，这个 事情是非常容易被完成的，但是他要我们在地上的人教会来完成。
And so the angel says,
所以这个天使说
I can tell you you're saved.
我会告诉你你得救了。
You're accepted by God.
你已经被上帝给
But you need some Bible study.
接受了，但是你
You need some instruction.
你需要查经，需要一些指导。
That's why we have the church.
所以我们才有教会。
Let the church do the job.
让教会做这个工。
So Cornelius says, wonderful, great.
所以哥尼流说很好。
And he sends a delegation to Joppa.
他就差派了这个一些人去到找去到约
翰。Now, my friends, let me ask you a question.
然后我问你一个问题。
Do you know another Bible story where Joppa is involved, the city of Joppa?
你记得这个约帕还有在哪里在圣经被记载到吗
？Is there any other famous Bible story that plays in Joppa?
还有什么这个圣经的记载的故事呢？说到约帕。
What story?
什么故事
？Oh, you're sleepy.Some of you are actually sleeping right now. I'm seeing that.
我看到有人在睡觉。
So wake up, man.
起来。
What story? Jonah.
对的，约拿。
Now remember the story of Jonah.
你们记得约拿的故事吗
？What was his call?
他被呼召做什么
？Go to Nineveh.
去到尼尼微城。
Preach the gospel.
你们要他要宣讲。
Tell me who lived in Nineveh.
告诉我说谁是住在尼尼微城呢
？Jews.
犹太人吗
？Samaritans，
撒玛利亚人吗
？Assyrians，
是亚述人。
Now Assyrians had what connection to the Jews？
亚述人和这个犹太人有什么关联呢
？It was their deadliest enemies，
就是他们的敌人啊。
Now Assyrians were not to play with。
亚述人呢，并不是他们好朋友。
All of you who came to my seminar, you know the Assyrians were fearful people。
如果你们才参加我的工作坊，你们知道这个亚述人呢是非常恐怖的。
If they don't like you，
如果他不喜欢你的话
，they will take you，
他会抓你。
While you're still alive，
然后你还是活着
，and take away your skin，
然后就剥了你的皮。
Would you like to go to Nineveh and preach the gospel？
所以你会想要去尼尼微来宣道吗
？I mean, let's make this real。
然后呢？
Imagine God is giving you a dream tonight.
你在想，如果今晚上帝赐福你一个梦
，and is saying I put you on a plane ticket.
他说我给你机票
，that will bring you to Pyongyang.
叫你去平壤
，the capital of North Korea.
就是朝鲜的首都。
I want you to be the missionary to Pyongyang, preach the gospel in North Korea.
我要你在朝鲜传讲我的信息。
Would you go?
你会去吗？
Or do you understand Jonah a little bit better?
所以你现在比较明白这个约拿怎么想的吧
？So instead of going to Nineveh, he went to Joppa.
所以呢，虽然他没有去到尼尼微，他就逃跑去约帕。
And decided to flee to Spain.
他决定呢要逃跑去这个西班牙。
So in that city,
就在那个城市
，a man of God had decided not to preach to the enemies of God's people.
这上帝的孩子呢，他不想要去这个尼尼微宣教。
Now hundreds of years later. Once again, a man of God is in the city.
又多一次呢，这个上帝之子呢，在这个城市。
Once again, the opportunity is there to preach to the deadliest enemies of God's people, the Roman army.
又再次的这个人呢，他需要和这个敌人，就是罗马的这些兵队呢，来传讲福音。
Will the man of God now do the job?
那上帝的孩子会做这个事情吗？
Every angel in heaven was watching.
每个天使在天国都在观看。
Will he have learned the lesson of Jonah?
他会被学习到这个约拿的故事的教训。
Or will Peter repeat the mistake?
还是彼得呢？又犯重蹈覆辙犯错
？Now, my friends, let me be very clear.
我的朋友，你听听。
I think I still have a few minutes, right?
我看我还剩下15分钟 ，15 minutes.
15 minutes. Oh, wow, I need to go. We'll have an appeal later on.
然后这个彼得他怎样
？I will already tell you what the appeal will be.
我告诉你彼得会怎样。
There are Romans and Assyrians today.
今天呢，还有罗马的亚述人。
That are unreached.
他们还我们打不到他们。
God needs someone to go.
上帝需要有人来帮助。
And as we progress in our study,
所以当我们继续在研经的时候
，start to think.
你们想想
，Is God maybe calling me?
是不是上帝其实呼召我
？Now listen to me.
听我说。
To devote my life.
就要献上我的生命。
To reach an unreached people group in this part of Asia.
在这个亚洲，我们所传扬福音、传扬不到的人，是不是上帝呼召你要去与他们宣教
？No one was reaching the Romans.
没有人去到这个宣教给罗马人。
God needed someone to preach to the Romans.
上帝需要有人去传讲福音给这些罗马人。
We are calling ourselves the army of youth.
我们叫自己呢年轻人的兵丁。
God needs someone to do the work.
上帝需要人做这个工。
Let's go on.
让我们继续。
Verse 9.
第九节。
The next day, as I went on the journey and drew near the city, Peter went up on the housetop to pray about the sixth hour. Then he became very hungry and wanted to eat.
第二天，他们行路将近那城，彼得约在五镇上房顶去祷告，觉得饿了，想要吃。
Question.
问题。
Now you need to be awake and think.
你必须要清醒，然后想想。
Do you remember any other story in the Bible?
你还记得其他的这些圣经故事
？Where someone was hungry.
说到有人饿了。
And prayed.
然后祷告。
At the sixth hour of the day.
就在这个镇午镇时。
Someone that was at a place in the sixth hour of the day.
就是有一个人呢，在这个午镇的时候祷告。
And was hungry.
然后他又饿了。
Anyone remember the story?
你们记得这个故事吗
？I will tell you.
我会告诉你。
You can find it in John 4.
你可以在约翰福音第四章。
Where Jesus is sitting at the well at the sixth hour of the day.
当耶稣在午镇坐在这个井旁边。
Being hungry.
他饿了。
Right?
对吗
？Now question.
问题。
In John 4.
在约翰福音第四章。
What's the main idea in John 4?
这个最主要的理念是什么
？Is it not that Jesus is bridging the gap to the unreached Samaritans?
难道不是耶稣要把这个福音传扬给这些我们抵达不到的撒玛利亚人吗
？Is not the bottom line of the story that Jesus is willing to reach to those that the Jews thought they can never be reached?
最主要是耶稣他愿意去接触这些以色列人永远都不会去接触的人。
Now go with me to John 4.
所以我们可以去到约翰福音第四章。
Reading verse 31.
第三十一节。
After he had talked to this stranger lady,
在他和这个陌生的这个妇女讲话过后
，making her a Bible worker in just a few hours,
他已经和他的宣扬他向他宣讲道理了。
The disciples came back.
这个门徒回来了。
In the meantime, his disciples urged him, saying, "Rabbi, eat."
三十一节，这期间门徒对耶稣说：“拉比，请吃。
”But he said to them,
耶稣说
"I have food to eat of which you do not know."
我有食物吃，是你们不知道的。
So the disciples were saying,
然后门徒彼此说
"Did he go already to the restaurant?"
难道他已经自己去了餐馆吗
？Did someone bring him some rice?
有人给他饭吃了吗
？Has anyone brought him anything to eat?
有人买东西给他吃吗
？Now listen to the next verse.
然后听这下一句。
Jesus said to them.
34节，耶稣说
：“My food,
我的食物
is to do the will of Him who sent me and to what to finish the work.
我的食物就是遵行差我来者的意。
Now we often talk about finishing the work.
做成他的工。
In Jesus' words, finishing the work means reaching the unreached.
对耶稣来说，这做成他的工呢，就是去触碰那些不能触碰的人。
Can you see that from the text?
你从这个圣经章节看得到吗
？Finishing the work means reaching the unreached.
做成他的工，就是去接触那些不能接触的人。
And he compares this to eating.
他这个就和吃饭拿来做一个对比。
Now in Acts.
现在在使徒行传。
Sixth hour.
午时。
Peter's hungry.
彼得肚子饿了。
And he is about to be challenged to reach the unreached.
他呢就被挑战，他要去接触那些不能接触的人。
How does Jesus explain this to him?
耶稣怎样解释
？With the symbol of eating.
他就用这个吃来表示。
The symbol of food. Did you see this?
你有看到吗？这个食物来代表。
And he brings out food from heaven.
他就把这个食物降从天上降
下来。Peter has this vision.
他就这个意象。
The food is coming.
这个食物从天上降下
来。But somehow it's not just rice and noodles.
然后并不是饭和面。
It's not even durian.
也不是榴莲。
It is all kinds of animals.
是所有的动物。
Some of them surely unclean.
很多都是不洁净的。
And Jesus says,
但是耶稣说
"Kill and eat."
杀了吃了他。
Now, when you understand the parallel to John 5,
如果你看到这个和约翰福音第五章他们是平行的。
What does eating mean in that situation?
那石头他吃是什么意思呢
？Finishing the work.
就是做成他的工。
And finishing the work.
做成他的工呢
？Means reaching the unreached.
就是接触那些不能接触的。
So it has nothing to do of whether we can eat pork or not. No.
其实并不说到我们可以吃猪肉。
He was saying there's people there.
他是说那里有人。
That you call unreachable.
他们呢叫做不能接触的人。
You call unlawful, unclean.
你们叫做呢他们不洁净的，不是合乎法律的。
You call them sinners.
你叫他们罪人。
But I have cleansed them.
但是我洁净他们。
If they believe in the cross, they will be as much as church members as you are.
如果他们愿意来到我十字架，我愿意。
So when Peter sees this vision.
所以呢，彼得看到这个意象。
And Jesus says, "Kill and eat."
耶稣说杀了吃。
What is his reaction?
然后彼得是什么反应
？No.
不。
He openly says unto the face of Jesus, no.
他明明白白在耶稣面前说不。
Because my tradition,
因为呢，我所教导传统
呢，my church,
我的教会呢
，my upbringing tells me I cannot do that.
我的成长过程中教导我不能这样做。
So Jesus gives the vision again.
所以耶稣又给了一个意象。
How often does he give the vision in total?
他总共给了几次呢？
Three times.
三次。
How often had Jesus told him, tend my sheep?
耶稣问了他几次要喂我羊，告诉他。
Three times.
三次。
How often had Jesus had Peter denied him?
然后呢，彼得说我爱你多少次呢？
Three times. Now three times he's telling him, go and preach to the heathen in symbolic language.
也是三次呢，他用这个意表性呢，告诉他你去要对这些外邦人来传道。
But Peter still is not quite sure what this means.
但是呢，彼得还是不是很确定这个是什么意思。
We pick up the story in Acts.
我们再去看。
Chapter 9 and chapter 10.
第十章。
17. Now while Peter wondered with himself what the vision which he had seen meant, behold, the men who had been sent from Cornelius had made inquiry for Simon's house and stood before the gate.
第十七节，彼得心里正在猜疑之间，不知所见的异象是什么意思。哥尼流所差来的人已经访问到西门的家，站在门外。
Now my friends, did we see this before?
我的朋友，你们有看过这个章节吗？
A delegation coming to the house of Peter.
有一个代表团呢，来到彼得家里面前。
Knocking at the door.
在敲门。
Did we see this before?
你有看到这个吗？故事吗？
Yes or no?
有没有？
Did we see this before?
你有看过吗？昨天。
Yes, and the story before.
是，就是之前的那个。
And the last story of Acts 9.
就是在最后的这个第九章。
A delegation was coming to Peter's house.
又有个代表团呢，来到彼得的房间。
Knocking his door.
他正在敲门。
He opened.
他打开门。
And said, "What's the problem?"
他说什么问题？
And they said, "We have a dead person."
他说我们有个死人。
And so what did he say?
然后他说什么呢？
Let's go.
我们走。
Now a delegation is coming.
现在又有这个代表团来了。
They're knocking the door.
他们在敲门。
And what's their problem?
他们是什么问题？
It's a pagan person.
是一个异教徒。
What would have happened?
会发生什么事呢？
If Peter would have seen three visions.
如果呢，彼得看到这三个异象。
I guess he would have said.
他会说。
I'm not quite sure.
我不太确定。
Whether I can do this.
我是否可以这样做？
You know, it's actually unlawful.
因为呢，这是不守律法的。
If you want me to help a dead person, no problem.
如果呢，你是一个死人，没关系。
I'm willing to resurrect a dead person, but I'm kind of hesitant to help a pagan.
如果是死人，我愿意把他复活。可是呢，你是异教徒。
Right? Is that incredible?
你不觉得很奇怪吗？
So Peter would have said.
所以彼得应该说。
If the person is dead, no problem. I will go.
如果这个人死是没问题，我去。
If the person it belongs to another race and religion, I don't know whether I can go.
可是问题是，当这个人呢是属于某个宗教、某个种族的话呢
，So God needs to give him three visions.
所以呢，上帝需要给他三个意象。
And because that is not enough.
因为那个是不足够的。
The Holy Spirit directly speaks to Peter.
这个圣灵呢，直接跟彼得交流。
Pushing him.
他推他。
I mean, the Holy Spirit didn't push him to resurrect the dead person.
这个圣灵并没有推他去复活这死人。
Peter had enough faith to resurrect a dead person.
彼得呢有足够信心去把这个死人复活。
But when it came to reaching the unreached, the Holy Spirit really needs to push him.
但是当到来到这些呢，不能接触、不能被传讲福音的人呢，这个圣灵需要推他。
Three times Jesus had to give him the vision.
三次，耶稣需要给他三次的异象。
And then additionally, the Holy Spirit had to say, "You must go."
然后呢，再加上呢，这个圣灵推他，告诉他你必须去。
Listen to verse 9.
让我们看 ，Pardon.
While Peter thought about the vision, the Spirit said to him, "Behold, three men are seeking you."
这里呢，第九十九节说，彼得还思念那异象的时候，圣灵向他说，有三个人来找你。听清楚。
Arise, therefore, go down and go with them, doubting nothing.
二十节，起来下去，和他们同往，不要疑惑。
Rise up,
起来。
Rise up,
起来。
Rise up,
起来。
And go,
and go, 去。
Could it be more clear?
你们明白吗？
God is not,
上帝没有
intimidated by human laws.
让这个律法而捆绑着。
Because all power,
因为所有的力量
and all might,
所有的大能
and all authority is given to Jesus.
所有权力都是属于耶稣的。
And his command to me and to you,
他已经叫你和我
is not mysterious,
并不是不需要疑惑的。
Go to every nation, kindred, tongue, and people,
去把福音传给各国、各方、各族、各民。
And sometimes we like to do great works for the church.
更多时候呢，我们想要在教会行大事。
Organize wonderful conferences.
我们主办了很多的大会。
Do wonderful Bible work.
做了很多的这些圣经的工作。
And if need be, we would even resurrect the dead people.
有可能呢，我们还可以使这个死人复活。
But going to the unreached.
可是呢，当我们说到宣传福音给
这些
不能被触碰的
a different religion,
种族还有信仰
if it may be even dangerous.
因为有可能会有危险。
We need the Holy Spirit to really push us.
我们需要圣灵来推我们去做。
So you may ask yourself.
所以你会问你自己。
So what are you talking about unreached people? Who are the unreached people?
你说这些不可触碰人是谁呢
？I will tell you.
我告诉你。
I mean, I'm not from this area of the world.
我并不是从这里来的。
Probably you know even better.
你应该知道。
In this area of the world.
在我们这个世界这里。
The Adventist Church is present in almost every nation.
在每一个国呢，在每一个国呢，都有这个福音的教会。
But there are still many people groups that have not almost not reached.
但是呢，还有很多族的人呢，他们并不能够被接触。
I'm talking about the Buddhists in Thailand.
我就是说到在泰国的这个佛教徒。
I'm talking about the Muslims in Cambodia.
还有呢，在这个柬埔寨的穆斯林教会。
I'm talking about the Buddhists in Cambodia.
还有在这个柬埔寨的佛教徒。
And yes, I am talking about the Muslims in this very country.
我也说到呢，在我们这里国家的穆斯林。
I'm talking about the inhabitants of Brunei.
我也说到呢，这个在这个 Brunei 的。
And I'm sure there are more groups.
还有很多很多。
Maybe some tribes in the forest. I don't know.
也许呢，在这个森林里面的。
You may know them better.
你知道比较知道。
Someone needs to go there.
有人需要去接触他们。
And if we have one conference after another conference,
我们有了很多的这些大会。
And we enjoy ourselves, and we have the sweet spirit at united prayer.
我们有这个一起的祷告，联合祷告，我们在享受这些大会。
And we have the most wonderful sermons.
有非常好的讲座。
But these people are unreached. God looks down and he sees ruins.
的讲道，可是呢，这些人呢，并不能接触，他们要荒凉了。
We call ourselves the army of the Lord.
我们叫我们是上帝的精兵。
Someone
有人
must go.
一定要去。
No, I'm realizing not everyone will go.
现在我知道不是全部人都能去。
I'm realizing not everyone is called to do pioneer work.
我知道呢，并不是每个人都被呼召做前锋。
In some of these areas,
在有一些地方呢
，we cannot even finish the work because we have hardly begun the work.
我们呢都不能完成工作，因为我们根本都没有开始。
But when Peter was willing to go,
但是彼得他愿意去。
He made a bridge into the wall.
他在这个墙上打了一个洞。
Of separation.
就把这个隔绝呢，离开了。
He still was hesitant.
他还是非常的疑惑。
He was obedient.
他虽然顺从。
So when he entered the house of the Cornelius,
当他进到这个哥尼流的屋子的时候
，the first thing he said, you know, it's unlawful.
他一个第一话句话就说这不合理法。
But at least he listens to him.
但是呢，他还是和他们一起。
But you know what happened?
你知道发生什么事
？When Cornelius gave his testimony,
当哥尼流给他见证的时候
，when Peter was in interaction in one-to-one Bible study,
当彼得和他做一对一的查经的时候
，finally it clicked.
终于他明白。
And Peter said, "Now I perceive."
彼得说 ，Now 现在我知道。
There are some things you can only understand if you're in the field.
如果你在这个做的时候，你才能够明白。
Some things can only be understood if you talk to the people one to one.
有些时候呢，你才能够明白，当你一对一的交谈。
Now let me be very clear.
现在呢
，When Peter went there, I know the time is up.
我知道没有时间了。
So you can hold it down.
你放下来。
When Peter went.
当彼得走的时候
，It created trouble in the church before peace.
他在教会的时候已经有一个做了一个问题。
And you know what?
你知道吗
？Peter eventually died.
彼得最后死了。
Killed by a Roman soldier.
他被这个罗马的兵丁杀死。
But he did what God asked him to do.
但是呢，他做了上帝叫他做工作。
And because of his work.
因为他的工作。
Then in the next chapters, we read about Paul breaching out to other Gentile areas.
在下一章我们看到保罗呢，他去传讲给外邦人。
And the second part of the book of Acts is only Gentile mission all the time.
在使徒传的下半部呢，都是说到传讲福音给外邦人。
So someone says we need to do the next step.
所以有人就说我们需要跨向迈进一步。
It is not acceptable for the last 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, these people have been unreached.
可是呢，在过去的十、二十、五十年呢，这些人都还没有被接触到。
Jerusalem lies in ruins.
耶路撒冷还是在这个荒凉。
Where is the Nehemiah of today?
谁要做这个前锋
？Who says enough?
谁说够了
？Enough of this.
够了，这些都够了。
I will go.
我会去。
And if I'm the only person,
我是只有一个人。
God will send help.
上帝也愿意。
You know Nehemiah took only 52 days to finish the work.
尼西米他只用了52天就完成了工作。
So I need to close.
所以我现在要结束。
I think it's already very clear the appeal is coming.
我觉得你们很清楚这呼召已经来了。 所以要祷告。
In Acts 15.
在使徒行传。
Years later, when the church general conference came together.
然后他们一起去到这个聚会。
And they discussed this topic of reaching the unreached Gentiles.
然后他们一起讨论呢，要怎样接触这些外邦人。
Listen to the final conclusion by Simon, the older brother of Jesus, the head elder of the church in Jerusalem.
听到了这个西门这个耶路撒冷的长老所做的总结。
Simon has declared how God had the first visited the Gentiles to take out of them people for His name.
Sorry, which was?
Verse 14.
15:14. 15:14.
Yes.
15:14节，这里说到方才西门述说上帝当初怎么样眷顾外邦人，他从他们中间选拔取百姓归属于自己的名下。
And with this, the words of the prophets agree, just as it is written.
众先知的话也要与这意思相合。
After this, I will return and will rebuild the tabernacle of David.
此后我要回来重建建造大卫倒塌的帐幕。
Which has fallen down.
把那破坏的。
I will rebuild its ruins and I will set it up.
重建修造建立起来,
so that the rest of mankind may seek the Lord, even all the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord who does all these things.
叫取义的人就是凡称为我名下的外邦人都得寻求主。
In the Bible, the work of reaching the unreached is compared of rebuilding the city.
在这里呢，这里说到呢，去触碰这些呢外邦人，就和这个重建这个城市是说的一样的。
It would be a shame. If an army of youth gathers for a weekend,
如果呢，我们耶稣的精这个年轻人精兵呢，在这个周末聚集，
talking about rise and build,
就说到建起来建造，
and not one would be found who would be actually able to rise and build.
但是呢，我们发现呢，竟然没有一个人可以起来建造。
Now, is God calling you?
现在是上帝叫呼召你
to devote your life,
要你献上你的生命
to reaching an unreached people group,
去触碰那些不能触碰的人。
Either as a pastor.
你或者是,
or a medical nurse,
或者可能你是护士,
or a doctor,
或者医生,
or a mechanic,
或有可能是这些, 机械员工,
you don't need to be a full-time minister to reach an unreached people group. You can work in your job,
你可以现在在你的工作中,
but just move in that land,
只是你去到那个地方,
open your shop among that people.
在这些人的当中开一家店,
is there anyone here today?
今天呢，有谁
who would be willing to make that life-changing decision?
愿意想做这个生活中的巨大改变。
To say, my life work,
说我的生活当中，
shall be to reach an unreached people group.
我们要去触碰宣讲这个故事给这些不触碰的人。
Every other decision,
每一个决定，
what job I will take,
什么我要做什么工作，
whom I marry,
我要嫁给谁，
where I live,
我要住在哪里，
should be considered under this heading of reaching the unreached.
都需要呢，在这个不能触碰、不能触碰的人的这个目标之下。
If God is calling you,
如果上帝是呼召你，
don't say,
你们不要说，
but I need to work for the Chinese church in Malaysia.
我只需要在这个马来西亚和这个华人的教会工作。
You know why?
你知道吗？
Because the majority of you will not follow.
因为很多，they
will not follow to this appeal.
因为很多人呢都不会接受这个呼召。
There will be plenty of workers to do the Chinese work here.
在这里呢，还有很多的工人会做这个工作。
So if God is calling you,
所以如果上帝呼召你，
it's because He needs you.
是因为他需要你。
And so here's my appeal.
所以这是我的呼召。
I will not make play music.
我并不会有音乐。
I will not even make you stand up all.
我也不会叫你站起来。
Because it takes courage for this work.
但是呢，你要有勇敢。
So I'm looking for those who are courageous to even stand up alone and come forward.
所以呢，如果你愿意的话呢，你就站起来来到前面。
It's in this army of youth.
这个就是我们年轻的精兵。
Any Nehemiah.
所有的人，
or Nehemiah, yes, I don't know, like what the female name is.
有可能是尼西米。
A man or woman.
男生或者女生。
A boy or girl.
一个小男生或者女生。
I want to say today,
想要今天，
I want to devote my life to reach unreached people groups.
我要献上我的生命触碰那些不能触碰的人。
And if that's the case,
如果是这样的话，
and if it's only one,
如果有一个人，
that will be a victory for eternity.
就是让我们能够得胜。
I invite you to come forward right now.
我邀请你现在来到面前。
Amen.
Amen.
Now don't come if you feel just emotionally motivated.
你千万不要因为你的情绪而感动你。
Before you come,
但你来之前呢，
think about that angels register your decision.
你要想想这个天使呢会记下来在你的决定。
I would be happy if just one came. I'm amazed that so many are coming.
其实只有一个人来到，我会很开心。我现在非常惊奇的这么多人。
Don't take that lightly.
你们不要轻易做决定。
So if God is calling you, come.
如果上帝呼召你来。
If God has called you to be a faithful witness in Chinese community, that's fine. He needs you as well there.
如果上帝呼召你是在华人的种族中做这个宣传工作，没问题。
But God needs someone to reach the unreached.
但是呢，上帝需要那些触碰不能去接触这些不能触碰的人。
I don't want to make this long.
我不要太长。
I will not tell you where to go.
我也不会告诉你你需要去哪里。因为圣灵会告诉你。
You may need training.
你也许
you can go to Salt.
你可以去到这个 Salt.
You can go to IEAT.
你也可以去到 IEAT.
You can go to AFM.
你也可以去到 AFM.
The Holy Spirit will teach you.
就圣灵会教你怎么做。
That's not my job to tell you.
并不是我的工作。
My only job to tell you is God needs someone to go.
告诉你，而是呢，我的工作是告诉你，上帝需要一些人去做。
God be the glory.
愿上帝的荣耀。
Let's kneel down and pray.
让我们一起跪下来做个祷告。
Dear Father in heaven,
我们在天上的父
，Thank you，
感谢你
，for reaching out to us，
让你带领我们
，Thank you for waking us up，
感谢您让我们警醒
，Thank you for speaking to our hearts，
感谢您向我们心灵诉说
，And thank you that the message is not difficult to understand，
感谢主您这个信息是容易明白的
，It may have been plain。
也许很简单的
，But you are longing for someone to reach those who haven't been reached.
但是呢，主，你现在要想要有这些不能接触的人被接触。
So I praise you.
所以我赞美你。
That you have worked on so many hearts.
你已经呢，在这么多人的心中运行着。
And I'm sure that you have worked on their hearts long before the sermon even started.
我也确定了，在我还没有讲到之前呢，你已经在他们心里中运行着。
So this morning.
所以今天早上。
We commit ourselves into your hands.
我把我们交托在主您的手中。
I want to ask for everyone who came forward.
我要要求所有这些来到前面的人。
That you may bless them abundantly.
你会大大的赐福于他们。
That you may teach them.
你会教他们。
Where to go, what to do, how to train.
他们要去哪里，要怎样被受训。
Everyone is different.
每一个人都不同。
Every circumstance may be different.
每个情况也不同。
Every case is different.
每一个事件都不同。
So we cannot prescribe a narrow course.
所以呢，我们并不能给他们小小的。
This is why we need to trust you.
所以呢，我们需要相信您。
But I pray that those who have come forward.
但是我为这些将前来的祷告。
Will never forget that decision.
我永远都不会忘记这个决定。
That you have called them to do something special for unreached people groups.
因为呢，主你呼召他们去向这些不能被触碰的人传讲。
Send them to the places where their gifts and talents may be of the most effective.
请主您差派他们去到他们所拥有的这个能力才干所能持守的。
Give them experience that will help them to be leaders.
给他们经验，能够让他们作为领袖。
And later train others as well.
然后也可以去训练其他人。
Thank you that you are going to finish this work.
感谢主，您要完成这个工作了。
Thank you that you are doing this with our cooperation, although angels could do it much better.
感谢主，您并没有差派天使做这个工作。
And I pray for everyone else.
我也为其他人祷告。
That they will support these young people.
因为他们会扶持这些年轻人。
And not hinder them.
然后不会阻碍他们。
That they will give them counsel and advice.
他会给我们好的这些辅导。
And strengthen them instead of weakening them.
加强他们，而不是减弱他们。
Let us stand together.
让我们一起站立。
Let this be a group of new pioneers.
这一个是最前锋的人。
Breaking new ground for the gospel.
他们要去新的地方为你站立。
So that we may hasten the coming of our Lord and Jesus Christ.
所以呢，就是有主基督的再临。
In His mighty name we pray.
奉主耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
请坐。